Selenium, a powerful and open source testing platform that is being used extensively by most of the largest corporations in this world. So this is what we are going to talk about in today's session. So what's there in the agenda for today's video? So first of all, we are going to look at what is Selenium, then its purposes, different components of it, and of course, then we'll be seeing one hands-on, and finally, career opportunities you can have in this particular field. Now let's suppose, what if your Facebook account gets hacked? Or let's say, if you found out that your online transaction went to the wrong person. So in such a scenario, the right software testing automation actually would ensure that these issues don't affect your life. And that is why we have got Selenium in place, which is a tool that is used for software testing automation. So what is it exactly? So Selenium is a free open source automated testing platform for web applications across different browsers and platforms. And it basically focuses only on automating web-based applications. Now this is just not a tool, or rather this is just not a single tool, but a platform of software, each catering to different testing needs of an organization. So it basically has got four components. The first one is Selenium Integrated Development Environment, or let's say IDE. Then Selenium Remote Control, or RC, Webdriver, and finally Selenium Grid. And now Selenium RC and Webdriver are merged into a single framework to form Selenium 2. And as I told you guys that since Selenium is a collection of different tools and hence, it is developed by different persons as well. So initially, Selenium was created by Jason Huggins in 2004. So he actually was working on a web application that required frequent testing. But then he eventually realized that these repetitive manual testing was becoming more and more inefficient in their applications. And then this dissatisfaction led to the creation of a JavaScript program that would automatically control the browser's actions. And he named this program as the JavaScript Test Runner, which ultimately later on became an open source and again got renamed as Selenium Core, and this is how Selenium came to existence. Now, one obvious question you might be getting, when we already have various software testing tools just like QTP, then why do we need Selenium? So, you know, let me list out some of the key differences between QTP and Selenium to give a clear picture to you guys. So QTP is a commercial tool and hence it requires a license which is expensive. Whereas Selenium is a free open source tool and does not require any kind of licensing. Now again, QTP is restricted to specific web browsers such as Firefox and Internet Explorer, whereas Selenium has capabilities to execute a script across different browsers. Now QTP works only with Windows, but then Selenium can be used on various operating systems. So QTP also requires third-party tools to support mobile devices, but then Selenium directly supports all types of mobile devices. Now QTP supports only VB scripts, whereas Selenium supports mature object-oriented languages just like Java. So by looking at all these points, we can simply conclude that Selenium works more efficiently than other tools in the market. So as we've already discussed that Selenium has got four components. So now let's look at each of them individually. So the Selenium IDE is an easy to use Firefox plugin, which is used to develop Selenium test cases. So it actually provides a graphical user interface for recording user actions using Firefox. But then it can only be used with Firefox browser as other browsers are not supported with it. However, the recorded scripts can be converted into various programming languages and then it can be executed on other browsers as well. Now, second on the list, we have got a Selenium RC. So using Selenium Core, testers actually had to install the whole application and also the web server on their local computers because of some kind of restrictions. And to solve this, Selenium Remote Control was developed. So in this, particularly, the software was created in such a way that browser is tricked to believe that both Selenium Core and the web application being tested come from the same domain. And hence, Selenium RC comes in two parts. Selenium Server, which interprets and executes the Selenium commands, and then Client Library, that provides an interface between programming languages and Selenium RC Server. And after this, we have got Selenium Webdriver. So Webdriver was created in around 2006. when browsers and the web applications were becoming more powerful and more restrictive with JavaScript. So it was the first cross-platform testing platform that could control the browser from the OS level. And also WebDriver interacts directly with the browser without any intermediary. Now WebDriver can be used in different contexts. Multi-browsing testing, handling multiple frames, pop-ups and alerts, complex page navigation, advanced user navigation such as drag and drops, and finally Ajax-based UI elements. And the last tool we have got is Selenium Grid. So this would actually distribute the tests across multiple physical or virtual machines, so that testers can execute scripts in parallel. That is, it allows the tester to execute multiple instances of WebDriver or Selenium remote control tests in parallel. So this includes the hub and the node. So hub would actually act as a server or the central point where the tests would be triggered. And nodes are the Selenium instances that are attached to the hub which execute the tests. Now that we know what Selenium is and its components are, let us move on to a hands-on exercise to understand how WebDriver uses cross-browser functions. Okay, so here we are going to understand the cross-browser testing using a WebDriver. So let's discuss how to instantiate either Chrome or Internet Explorer using web browser. Now let me guys tell you one thing, that here Firefox is the native browser supported by Selenium, and hence we do not need to use any kind of exe files specifically for Firefox. But then if we talk about Chrome or other browsers, then they are not supported directly by Selenium. And so for using these browsers, we need to download a separate exe files for this. Okay, so that is to say that other than Firefox, we need separate drivers, right? Or driver objects for each and every browser. Okay, so for that, you can simply download the latest driver for Internet Explorer from this place. So let me just click on that. And here you can go to Internet Explorer, see here. So from here, you can simply download it. But again, it also depends upon your system configuration. So this is for Internet Explorer. But then let's say if you want to download it for Chrome, then again, you need to download the latest version. Let me just scroll down from here. Okay, so both the files are zip files here. And inside that, you will be getting or you'll be finding the exe files. Okay, but then let me tell you that you need to save the paths for these exe files, because then these paths are going to be used into your applications. Okay, so let's go back to our downloaded folders, you know, so check whether we have got our exe files or not. So let me go back to in my folder. So Intellipaat and then workspace. So see here, both the exe files are available. So if you are going to open all these, you will be getting the exe files. So let me open that and see, we have got it for Chrome, right? And again, so this is for Chrome and this is for Internet Explorer. So we have got both the exe files over here. Now let me create a new class to understand the browser initialization. And for that, let me just create a new class over here. Go to new class and let me just give it a name. Okay, and click on public static void main, because we are going to need that method particularly. So my first method would be here to verify IE browser. So let me type in that. Okay, now how do you initialize your IE browser? So for that, there are a few steps that you need to remember before calling the IE browser, okay? So the first thing is that we need to set up our system property. Okay, so to set up the system property, you can say system.setProperty, which will accept two different parameters as key and values, right? So let me just do that for you guys. Okay. So here the key values are nothing but the webdriver.ie.browser, okay? And then the value will be the exact path where we are storing the exe files. Remember, I told you guys to remember that particular path. So let me copy that path. Okay, so we are going to copy the exact path from here for our Internet Explorer driver. So copy it and paste it over here. And then you also have to mention the file name including the .exe extension. So I'm just going to copy that one as well and paste it over here. Okay, now it is actually giving some compilation error. So this is due to the escape character of folder separator, right? So you have to provide the backslash as an escape character over here. So that's what I'm going to do all across. So let's do it. Okay, so once your property is set, we have to use desired capabilities class, right? So now we are going to use our desired capability class. So the class called desired capability in our Selenium API, which would help you to set up the properties for your browser object. Okay, so now first let's say the class in our API. Okay, so we are just going to find the desired capabilities class to understand it better. Okay, so here we have got this. Now let me just go to the desired capabilities class. Let me just go through it, Java doc, and here we'll be getting our desired capability class. So C and then D. Okay, so this is the one, you can see desired capabilities. Now see here, if I talk about this particular class, so it has actually got multiple methods, right? And each method is related to a specific object or let's say specific browser. So here you can see guys that each method or browser method is a static method, right? That's the static one. So when I say static, that means instead of calling or writing two different methods, you can simply call the method, right? Again, that is to say calling your method and initialize the capability object directly from the static method. Okay, so let me do that for you guys. So desired capabilities and directly Internet Explorer. Let me just go to the next line. So here the purpose of this capabilities is to initialize your web driver as same as the previous. So instead of using new Firefox driver, I'm going to say, let's say Internet Explorer drivers capabilities. Okay. So let me choose one, this one. So when you use the capabilities as a constructor parameters for a drive object, it is actually again going to use the same .exe files. See this .exe file that we talked about, right? Or rather it is going to use .exe file to initialize the drivers. So here for each and every browser apart from the Firefox, you must use the .exe file provided by the Selenium HQ team. And now our driver is ready. So once your driver or IE driver is ready, then I'm going to use get method to open my simple Google site. So let me do that now. So now let me get in the get method so that we can open my simple Google site. And let me just type in the domain from over here. Let's copy this and paste it over here. So now your drive object is ready. And now let's execute and understand whether is it initializing the Internet Explorer browser properly or not. So let's check it out then. So here Internet Explorer browser is going to be launched using our web driver. Okay, so now let's wait for the result. Okay. So see, we have now successfully launched our Internet Explorer using our web driver, right? Okay, now you can exactly use the same logic to initialize your Chrome browser. Right now we work for Internet browser, Internet Explorer, now Chrome browser. But then here use the same system property just with your Chrome property. Okay, so again, let me write the code for it. And then the value with the exact folder location along with your .exe file name. So let me go ahead. So public static void verify Chrome. Okay. And then let me copy this from here and paste it over here, or rather let me type in. Okay. So just get it again. You need to give the same path. So first of all, it is webdriver.chrome this time, right? Dot driver. And then the same path you need to copy and the exe file location as well. So let me copy the path. Okay, and then the name of the exe file. So this is the name of the exe file. So let me again copy it and paste it over. And do not forget to give the escape character to get out of your compilation error. And then again, we are going to call the desired capabilities. And this time we are calling Chrome method, right? And since it is a static method, so again, we do not need to create any different methods. So instead of creating a new object and then calling the method, we are directly using the method itself, just like we did with Internet Explorer, right? And now we are going to use our Webdriver object. So let me again type in for that. So this is again, which is Chrome driver capabilities, right? And then once your browser is ready, you can simply directly call your get method. So let me do that for you guys. Let me call this get method. Okay, and save it. So let me just do a little bit of changes over here. Some spelling error. Okay, this is done. Now what? So now here we are going to call our Chrome method, right? Instead of IE browser. So we are using the same class, but calling different method, which will help us initialize Chrome browser for testing. So now let us test the result. What is the result? Whether we are going to initialize it or not. So let's wait for the result now. It is going to take a while. And see, we have got this. So see here, using web drivers, we actually kind of did cross browser testing, and that is how it actually works. I hope guys you got a fair knowledge about it. Now let's go ahead. And ultimately, let's talk about the career Selenium has got to offer you. So without the right testing process, no software can be released, and hence the salaries and demand for automation testing professionals will only increase in the future. So companies in diverse fields are actually deploying Selenium automation testing, but then there is a serious shortage of almost 4 lakh automation testing professionals across the world. And then you can also see average salary of a Selenium professional in USA, which is quite, you know, promising. And once you complete the course, you can choose your designation, just like Selenium test analyst, automation tester, automation engineer, quality engineer, and many more other designations awaiting you. And now let us quickly go through all that we have learned today so far. So we saw what is Selenium, then difference between Selenium and QTP. We then also looked at different components of Selenium, followed by a practical work, and finally career opportunities it has for you. And then Intellipaat offers the most comprehensive training in Selenium testing. And upon completion of the training, you can simply gain proficiency in Selenium, let's say IDE, RC, test, Webdriver, grid, etc. for software testing. And with this, we come to the end of this video. If you have got any query, feel free to contact us. Thank you so much for watching this video and giving us your precious time. I hope the video was informative for you. Please like the video, and if you have any doubt, comment below. We shall respond to it at the earliest. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more such informative videos. Do look out for other related videos in our playlist. For more detailed information, visit our website now. Have a great day and career ahead.